disagree with me on this. But this is the birthplace of the former president, General Idi Amin. And I know that Museveni has been speaking so much evil about General Idi Amin. But the roads and the schools and the hospitals that are standing today were built by General Idi Amin. He was in power for only 8 years. But Museveni has been in power for 35 years. But all he has done is to steal all the properties of Uganda, him and his family. That this is the birthplace of a great man called Francis Ayume. When I was a young boy, I used to read about him. And I know all of you still have questions about his death. Now listen to me, and listen to me very carefully. I am the president of the National Unity Platform. Listen to me carefully. I want to say this, and I know many of you might disagree with me. But I know that here in Koboko, there's also a young man called Charles Ayume. And I know that is in NRM. But I want you to tell him, I've not met him, but I want you to tell him that I've been watching him and I respect him. All of you, the people of Koboko, vote for that young man called Charles. Let me say this again. And I want you, the journalists, to cover this very clearly. I am asking you, the people of Koboko, to vote for that young man called Charles Ayume. Listen, I know he might not say anything good about me, but I understand. And I know that Charles Ayume will not come here to claim for a report of the death of Francis Ayume. Because very many families under Museveni have been intimidated. But because I am called Obini, I have no fear. That I've not come to Koboko to fight against fellow young people. I am not here to fight against the sons and daughters of Koboko. I am here for freedom and justice. I am here for the truth. I have studied Francis Ayume so much. And I know that he was one of the members of NRM. But like so many great men of Uganda that fought with Museveni in the past, When Francis Ayume saw that Museveni was going the road the wrong way, Francis Ayume said, stop. Francis Ayume was the Attorney General in 2004. And when he saw that Museveni was trying to change the constitution to remove the term limits, Francis Ayume disagreed with him. So all of you remember that he was coming from Masindi when he was in Masindi playing golf when he got a call and he was being summoned for a cabinet meeting. That is where he got the accident that he still questioned up to today. And we continue to demand for the report of the death of that great man. This is a generation that must get answers. Charles Ayume, wherever you are, I am telling you that you must stand firm like your father stood firm. We are not fighting against NRM. We are fighting against a dictator called Museveni. That is why even when I was coming here to Koboko, I came with my brother James Achidri from Maracha.
James Akiki, Maracha.
I met James Achidri in Parliament.
James Achidri Parliament.
He was a member of the NRM. But even if he was in NRM, the people of Maracha told him, don't change the constitution. The people of Maracha told him, don't touch the constitution. Change the battery. All right, make the boy them change up the battery. From NRM, the people of Maracha told him, don't touch the constitution. And he respected the people of Maracha because they are the one that
sent him
to the parliament. And that was the beginning of my friendship with Achidri James. And even if Achidri is running as an independent, I have requested the people of Maracha to vote for James Achidri. The same thing is with my brother, Oguzuli James.
James.
Please pardon me, Achidri James's name is stuck in my mind. I say the same thing applies to my brother, the Honorable Oguzuli Dennis. The member of parliament to Maracha's
name.
The Honorable Oguzuli Dennis is a member of the FDC.
And
I'm the leader of the National Unity Platform. But I've just asked the people of Maracha to kindly vote for Oguzuli Dennis. Because this is far, this is beyond political party. This is beyond tribe. This is beyond religion.
Yes, President.
We are standing together because we are removing a dictator. Tell your neighbor, we are removing a dictator. Why I am asking you to vote for me to be your president. It's because I want us as Ugandans to have a president who is a servant and not a boss. Let me say it again. We must have a president who is our servant and not our boss. The law in Uganda says all power belongs to the people. Not some power, but all power. So I am here to remind you that you have the power in your hands. How many of you are voters here? Now you are the people that are going to change Uganda. I say you are the people that are going to change Uganda. I can come here and talk to you. All these leaders can come here and talk to you. But the last power is in your hands. All the power is in your hands. Don't be intimidated by the guns. Don't be intimidated by the money. I will tell you that once you decide, everything is over. That is why even those people that have guns are coming to your house to give you 5,000, 10,000, beg to you to give you a t-shirt because they know you have that power. Now I want to ask you, my brothers and sisters, please don't leave this to us. Please don't leave this to me. I can only offer myself to lead you to a new Uganda. But it is your decision that will take us to a new Uganda. A Uganda where everybody will be equal. In a Uganda where you will not belong to a certain tribe to be in a certain position. Uganda where there will be equal opportunity for everybody regardless of your background. In a Uganda where there will be no tribalism. Let me say that again. In a Uganda where there will be no tribalism, I know that after 30 years, Museveni cannot tell any more lies. That is why he's telling lies even about we who are supposed to be his grandchildren. I know he has been telling the people of Koboko not to vote for me because I'm from I'm Uganda. I know he has been lying to the people of Koboko that when you vote for me there will be war. Let me ask you, the people of Koboko, when Museveni wanted to marry, he had to go to the same village where he comes from. But to prove to you that I'm not a tribalist like Museveni, I am married from the neighboring village from him. And his wife once grew up in the same house with my wife's grandfather's house. That proves to you that our generation is new. When we look at each other, we don't look at tribe. We don't look at religion. We don't look at gender. We are united by the pain we go through. And we are united by the dreams of a new Uganda that we want. That is who we are. And about the intimidation that if you vote for me there will be war. Excuse me, let me first laugh. My brothers and sisters, Museveni does not know anything apart from violence. But very sad for him that he can no longer intimidate us because he's very old. We are young people, we respect our elders very much. But we also know that we are young. We are nana, and we are strong, and we are united. Museveni is a person that cannot even chase a duck and catch it. We are going to use the law to remove Museveni. Because we know that the law is on our side. We know that the people of Uganda are on our side. And we know that the Almighty God is on our side. And now that God is on our side, nobody can be against us. When Museveni wanted to become president, he had to kill more than 500,000 people. He would come at night to talk to people. But me, I am coming daytime when everybody is watching. And I am telling you that we are removing a dictator. Now, how are we going to do that? How are we going to remove Museveni? How are we going to go to the new Uganda? I've already told you that you have that power. And I'm also telling you that you must use that power on your vote. I am telling you that you have that power and you must use it on the 14th of January. I am requesting all of you to make sure you vote. I know we are very many. But please don't say we are very many even if me I don't vote. No. We need every vote. I want us to win on every polling station. Even if there's somebody that you know that is sick or very old that cannot walk to the polling station, please help them to walk or ride them on a border to go and vote.